Mercury basically is a neurotoxin. It affects neurological development of fetuses and infants. And in very, very high concentrations, it can affect the neurological functioning of adults. The U.S. was the first country globally to institute regulations on mercury emissions from the combustion of coal. The concentration of mercury in coal is very, very low, part per billion, but we burn a lot of coal to generate electricity. When people see power plants and big plumes of white clouds, that's not where the mercury is. That's not where the toxins are. That's really probably mostly just water vapor that's condensing. Don't be worried about that. Worried about the thing that you can't see. The technology that my research focuses on is an existing technology, electrostatic precipitation. This primarily used around the world for removing particulates. So the ash, the incombustible component of coal. Broadly speaking, an electrostatic precipitator is a filtration process, but the reason it is preferred, it's far more widely used than the kind of the filters that you're imagining with your vacuum cleaner or with your indoor air cleaner, is because you don't have an actual medium that you're forcing a gas flow through in order to capture the particles. The advantage of this type of approach is that it allows you to reduce mercury emissions without adding a separate process, a separate device to the power plant. That process has been designed, developed, and built just for removing particulates. So basically it's charging the particles, exposing them to a very strong electric field, and then the particles with that charge drift toward the oppositely charged electrode within the electrostatic precipitator. The technology for removing mercury basically piggybacks on that. The mercury is actually absorbed not onto the ash that I spoke of earlier, but is absorbed onto another particle that you inject, so activated carbon. It looks more or less like laser printer toner, very, very fine powder, black in color, but it's very absorptive. That carbon particle is actually less well collected in electrostatic precipitators than the ash from coal. So now you've introduced a solution that has its own problems, so you're trying to remove mercury and these ash particles simultaneously. And so what we do is we do experiments and run numerical simulations to develop that optimization, to be able to say these are the conditions under which both mercury and particulates are removed optimally within this electrostatic precipitator. And that's generally where we're going in terms of air quality engineering is not requiring standalone independent processes to control each pollutant, because we know that that's more expensive, and we also know that to a greater and greater degree, it's combinations of pollutants that pose the greatest health threats.
As people are starting to recognize that you can actually place yourself in a computer-generated world and interact with it in a physical sense, I think this technology is just gonna blossom in the future. We are in the